Welcome back to the Younger Handyman channel. Today we're making blood orange gelato. If you don't know what blood orange gelato is, just like orange, it's like regular orange, but inside it's like blood red. So we're going to be using, of course, fresh oranges. We're going to be making 1 teaspoon of orange zest. I'm going to take my best orange here and make some zest out of it. If you don't know what zest is, then what's going to happen? So I'm going to press it this hard and then I'm going to like, do this. I'm going to press hard. We just finished making our orange zest. It smells like oranges.
That's amazing.
Now, David and I are going to squish fresh orange juice. Squeeze. First, we're going to cut these oranges in half. And then, we're going to use the machine. I'm going to try out how it works, and we're done cutting. Of course, we're not going to skip it. There. You have to be careful. Now we show how it looks inside. That's where the name comes from. Blood red. I'm almost finished cutting. There. Look at this. See, it's blood red. Oh, kind of.
Oh, I like this.
This is very different from regular. This is a lot more beautiful than regular for my opinion. What about your opinion, David?
It's favorite in my opinion.
Yeah. Now, I'm going to cut up more. First, in the second one. This one is the one where we made zest.
Let's
see how this one looks. This could look a little different. This is a little more blood red. Than that one.
Yeah.
I like that one more than this one, right?
Yeah, that's one.
There's this one. This is a little less blood red than the other ones. David, put these down. I have one more. Okay, we have more, but here's one.
And I think that's wrong and that's enough.
I don't think so. This has really thick skin. That's really weird. You ever seen this kind of orange?
I did.
Let's see what this one has. The last one was also a little
I already know that.
Let's see. This one has regular skin. No difference. Your regular orange says it's blood red. Because that's why it's called blood red orange. But no difference from the regular blood red orange.
Difference that's enough.
No.
Pass.
We have our oranges.
Oh, we have only two left, you see?
I know. One part, and then the second part.
The second part is big.
Don't kiss me.
It's lovely.
You like the taste, but you will never kiss it. And then we have our last orange. Oh, we have more. Not for gelato.
And I forgot to say that we're making a gelato.
Of course, this is gelato ice cream.
Well, gelato is a kind of ice cream.
Yeah. It's really nice, dude. So look, you see there's a little bit missing in the middle? That's the caramel that we got at this one. Okay? Which one should I grab first? I'm going to do this one.
Yeah, because I think this is the best.
So David's going to run the machine and I'm going to squeeze the juice. Now look how it works. So it's melting right now. And then I'm going to press on this. Like this. And to make the juice. What's the hour so far? That's how much. So let's take a water for first. That's how far we're heading now. Let's clap with your hands. Let's see how much juice is. Not that
much. I see juice.
Oh, there's a juice, just not a lot. I'm going to go at an 8.
I think we could more than that.
I don't think this is enough. Okay, next one. Let's put these at the side. Now this one. Now almost all the bottom is covered now, almost. I bet that's really hard for this to work. This also takes time. Don't just squeeze really hard.
Oh, and that is when Dan squeeze another one, okay?
But look, just the edge is left. Let's grab a smaller one now. This one. This one needs a little more.
Well, that is already full.
It's not done.
Oh, look at this big juice.
And now all is covered. Oh, the center is not the surface, really. Okay, this one's done. Now let's go to a huge one. Maybe the shortest one. This is almost done already. Almost, I said. This perhaps means more.
That's so good.
I pressed extra hard.
I was in there. Is enough?
Okay, this is enough. Now, let's go on to the next one.
Look at this.
This one is the same one that we did in the fence.
Wait a second. This orange grass I have.
This is not ever hat. This one don't wear a blue. This one was a very juicy one. We're just like one go and it's almost done. Almost, they said. Okay, this one's done. Yeah, we don't make snowmans out of these.
I know. It's been that this is not snow, and I'm making the water light.
Well, David, we don't play with food. Oh, broken food too. Some juice got in my eye. If you get orange juice in your eye or lemon juice, it might really stink. That's why I'm blinking to get it less stinky.
Yes, so
the good thing didn't go in your eye, too. You know, itching is not healthy. Cottage. Now after I'm done with this one, they're going to do one. Let's see, mine is about done. Oh, jeez. Now, I'm going to give you, do you want a small one or a big one?
I want the big.
Okay, here's a big one. Squeeze. All right. You may have to help. Just started. David is not strong enough to do it well. Because David didn't get the hang of it. I'm going to have to help him a little. This is not done. David, let me show you how it's going to be done. I'm going to do the age. That's not how we do the egg. That's how we do the egg. See? Just finished squeezing all of our oranges. As you can see, we squeezed as much as we could. More we could. If that we could, we would get all of it. But we couldn't get all of it. We got a lot of it. I'm just giving you a look. Got a lot, not all. Instructions said we need 4 cups, but we're not able to get 4 cups. We got almost 4 cups. Guys, we're going to check out the juice at that point. Here. Let's put it to the side right now. So we have our orange. So here's our orange juice with water in the bowl and make orange syrup. If you don't know how to make syrup, it's like getting like sap juice, and then you like get a lot of water away until it's like more of a syrup.
And
it's more like
and I'm going
it's less crummy.
And I'm going to sugar all the time.
David, look, what's going to happen? I'm going to bring it.
Now we add compound of salt.
No.
We add it out.
Now, David, say more clearly. Half a cup of sugar. David, we're not using the spoon.
No.
David, do not use the spoon. David, it's not a cup. You mean half a cup. So you guys do these because it's a quarter of a cup? I'm going to do the same thing with the milk. I mean the manila base. Dude, mix it faster. Okay, can I show you how it's done
first?
We'll do the rest and show you how fast it should.
That's fast?
Yeah, that's good. Steven, wait. Don't do it like this. You see, to do this. Do it like this. Leave it. You can't do it slowly. To make it super, we had to put it on our stove and make it simmer for 20 minutes. Now we're going to take it on our stoves. David, I'm going to do it. It's going to be a little heavy for you.
Oh my god, I'm going to mix it. Because I'm going to mix it.
David. Now David's going to try to eat it. David, left.
Left hand.
This one. Okay, you can't do it, so I've got to turn it on heating heat. Now simmer. Okay, let me help you. It's a little slow. There. Wow, David's mixing his syrup. I'm going to make the vanilla base. To make our classic vanilla base for our gelato using cornstarch. Every gelato that I know of uses the vanilla base. Now one more, then we're going to add our cornstarch.
Can I add it again?
David, no. Because I'm doing the vanilla base.
Oh, I don't mean you have to do all.
I'm not doing everything. It's a fair deal. You do another base. You add the vanilla base. And you did that. Now I'm going to measure out 3 tablespoons of cornstarch. Now 3 tablespoons of cornstarch. David, we're not adding the sugar for this one. Added the sugar for last time. 1, 2. This is a little more, so I'm going to have to get a little more off like this. And then our final. That's a little too much. Added a little less. The muscles add a little more. David. Now, I'm going to add the sugar.
Oh, I'm going
to add 3 the sugar. If you already watched my other gelato videos, you're familiar, right? Just top off a little bit. There.
I think that's too
big. Maybe. I'm making a little bit. And I would lessen one of these three, and that's a little bit more. This much more. Then I'm going to whisk all this together. First, we're going to add our orange zest. Even close up the sugar. Sugar is always at the bottom after we put it on. David, I'm whisking. It doesn't whisk very well. Until now. Now let's show you how this looks. Now this one is going to go and still simmer also, but for only 10 minutes. Like the rest of the vanilla paste. It's not just vanilla paste. Also, as you can see, there's the zest.
My drink is because this is really hard to me.
David, you stir fast.
So hard to me.
No. There, see? Over the other side.
And I think mine's beautiful because mine is
white is not just orange. There's also some orange zest.
Yeah.
It's a good combination of white and orange. You know, just one color, orange. David, can I help? Or is it too hot? I'll watch you mix mine.
Okay.
I'm going to take. This needs to be stirred a lot faster.
Oh, now I'm going to be here. I'm going to be here. Not that.
No, babe, not forever.
I know, not forever. That's only me mixing.
There, David. I'm done. Go a little faster at my speed. The reason why we want it to simmer is so thickens.
Okay, how many I already got marbles?
Because I'll get the same amount if I want to stir it very fast. The faster I stir it, the better. Not very fast, but this is the right speed. I think we think it should go a little faster than what they're doing right now.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not fast. You're slow.
I know, because it has to be slow.
You don't have to be slow, you have to be medium. And I'm medium. Mm-hmm. You're going slow.
Don't touch me.
Our syrup is complete, orange syrup. Now we're going to add it to the vanilla base. First, we're going to take it off our oven. Of course, I think we're going to do it this way first. Of course, we're going to mix it up. More like stir it up. Or whisk it. Before I combine them, we're going to use our whisk to blend. First, I want to show you how beautiful this is. Now what was good? Look, that beautiful anymore. Is this peach or what? This has a lot of detail. I'm gonna take our ice cream, the cool water to chill. Now it's not so hot anymore, that's why I'm not wearing the gloves. You have to know if it's hot or not if you don't want to wear gloves. Now I'll get the ice cream machine to cool. Now I've got to turn on the ice cream machine to cool. Now I've got to turn on the compressor. Doesn't matter the time, just want to look cool. We did about 10-15 minutes, and then we're going to pour in the ice cream, and then we're going to stir it. I'm going to click on this button, and it's done, and then it's going to like stir it like for like 60 minutes. It's going to become like more creamy. It's already been looking to begin more, and then we're going to serve it. We will see how David, I, and Grandpa and Grandma will try it. And Daddy will try it, right? Yeah. Of course, I'll try it too. Have not. Now we have our ice cream base. Cool, we're going to take it into our machine. Now we're pouring the gelato. Look at this. Sometimes there's a lot of ice cream in there, so the pressure has to not go up or not go at all. So something is it. It's a little different than what's on the camera. It's more like, it's not even brown, but it's more like, it's closer to brown than it looks. Yeah, it's more like orange than yellow than in the camera. Sometimes something happens when you're on the camera. Now it was a little light turn for half an hour, then we're going to try it. Give it to Grandpa, Daddy, me to try. I think the gelato is ready. There's a little bit of like concentration on this to be mixed up. I'm going to mix this up really well first. Now the third cup. They said this is the third and final. This is not final. gonna try my butt orange gelato. It's delicious. I'm a little having a brain freeze. I would have a little less now. Because I don't like brain freezes. Yeah, but how do you like this?
Oh, it's very nice. LA is beautiful.
Okay.
It's amazing. Delicious.
Okay.
First time I ate this ice cream with gelato. And I will eat.
Well, we made some earlier. Now let's see how Daddy likes it. It's delicious. Now let's let Daddy try it. I'm going to give Daddy a spoon.
Wow, it's one of the best.
What does it taste like? To me, it tastes like frozen. I can't tell the flavor much. There's a little bit of flavor, but when it's so cold, I can't tell the flavor a lot.
It tastes like delicious orange gelato.
Okay. Now let's let Grandma try it.
It tastes like orange. Thank you. You're the best.
This will be empty in 1 minute.
Thank you. I appreciate you. Wow. You know, every time you make it better.
I know, because I get so much better.
So what's the next step it's going to be?
We don't know.
I think
it will be raspberry.
Raspberry. I remember you did it, raspberry, no? No? Oh, okay.
You should be innovating your recipe.
Now I want to tell you this thing. David couldn't try in this video, so I did the other videos because he's sleeping. Thank you for watching. Join me next time. I hope you enjoy the next video and our previous videos, and of course, this video.
Very good.